Leon celebrating 25 years of serving our South Florida community. Leon Medical Center's medical excellence. And speaking of the South Florida community, it's a really special weekend around Lone Depot Park. We've got legacy stuff going all over the place. Those shipping containers finally figured out what's in them, right? And how about the uniforms? The City Connect unis looking great, honoring the Cuban Sugar Kings. It is fantastic. And oh, by the way, there's some baseball to be played tonight, as the NL East is certainly bunched in nice. The Marlins are 3 games under .500, but they are looking up at the New York Mets right now, the team that's in town, of course. And this is setting up to be a really, really special weekend. And oh, by the way, look who's pinch hitting for Todd Hollandsworth tonight. It's Tommy Hutton. Welcome aboard.
Well, thank you, Paul. I appreciate it. You know, I love the look of the unis. I love the look of the standings in the National League East. And I'll tell you what, I'm pretty well rested because it's been a while since my last start. I've been doing a little flat ground work with Minervini on Marlins Live, so I feel good about that. Right. I've had both vaccinations. I feel good about that.
Awesome.
I went 9 on radio a few weeks ago, so I think I can go 9 tonight.
I saw the pinch hitting numbers, too. That's fantastic. Most important question, how's your handicap?
Handicap has gotten worse, actually.
Who's going to start the game tonight for the Marlins? Well, it's going to be John Curtis, as the Marlins still trying to figure out that fourth or fifth spot in the rotation. Curtis has done this before, though.
Yeah, he has. The 28-year-old out of the University of Texas last year with Tampa Bay. By the way, he was tremendous in postseason for the Rays. But he had three opening starts for the Rays. The most he ever has gone, 2 2/3 last year. The most he's gone this year is 2 innings. So we'll see the rest of the bullpen tonight.
Good two-seamer. Pretty good slider.
And I think with the leg kicks.
There's a base hit into center field. Here comes a throw from Sierra. Gets to the plate. Picked by Leon. And he applies the tag. You gotta be kidding me. What a throw by Sierra. And what a play on the back end by Sandy Leon.
He thought he's had himself an RBI. No way. Great pick. Great tag. He stayed with it, too. Slapped it right on him.
It's been fun thus far. T. Hutt, I would love to. I mean, with all the power I have in this chair, I would love to give you a come from behind or maybe even walk off win.
I would like that. I would like to see that.
It's the least I could do.
We have time.
Yeah.
We have time.
Castro deals. And Cooper sends one in the air left field. This one's hit deep. This one's gone. We're tied in the seventh. Garrett Cooper does it again.
I told you you'd take advantage of these little situations. You get a guy who was showing 91 to 93 in Stroman. Cooper just got one out
through his only no-hitter as a member of the Cincinnati Reds. What a terrific pitcher. A great person. Saw a quote from Johnny Bench the other day. He said, and a man's man.
Yeah.
Tom Seaver.
Yeah, he is certainly sorely missed in New York. Mets fans, of course, but even in the baseball realm as well. And how'd you do against him? You remember?
Well, you know, they built the graphic, so it wasn't bad. And it was a pleasure to be able to say that. I mean, I wish I could have said that against a few more pitchers. But it was one of those things that when he pitched, all of a sudden I'd get the start. I'd get the start
again. Well.
And guys would come up and they'd say, hey, you're good for a couple hits tonight. It's a mental thing. Go back to what we were talking about before.
Right.
You get in your head, you're going to get two hits. And didn't matter who was out there.
To third, and they got him!
That's another thing we know about Jonathan Villar. We saw that in his time as a Marlin. Maybe he has speed on the bases, but many times he got picked off in situations that you didn't want him to get picked off. That's a good coordinated play between Brian Anderson and Simber. They got to coordinate that. He's got to get to the bag. Simber has to make the throw, and they got him.
No, he just
and
missed
a fly ball out to left. Maven there.